Okay, we have a summative coming up on complex number operations, so I'm going to run through some problems to help you get prepared for it. All right, so first off, we're going to be looking at simplifying powers of I. Now, what you want to remember is that I to the first power equals the square root of negative 1. We do that because you're going to come up with some negative square roots in the course of mathematics, and we know that there's no such thing as a negative square root. You can't find two numbers that you can multiply together to get a negative number. So the way we approach that is we factor out I and then we plow forward. And you're going to find this can be very helpful, especially in more advanced stages of mathematics. So you have I to the first power. Now I to the second, that means is you would take square root of negative 1 times square root of negative 1. Multiplying two of the same square roots basically gets rid of that square root symbol, and then you're just left with whatever's inside your radical. So in this case, I squared gives you negative 1. Now, if we do I to the third power, okay, we're doing square root of negative 1 times the square root of negative 1 times the square root of negative 1. We know a square root of negative 1 times the square root of negative 1 gives us negative 1, and then we're just left with an I at that point. So then we know that I to the third here is going to give us negative I, or a negative square root of negative 1. And here, when we get to I to the fourth, this is what we like. This is one I really like. Why we like this so much? Because you can basically break it up to I to the second times I to the second, and that's just negative 1 times negative 1. We get an answer of positive 1. We like dealing with ones in math. They're nice and easy. Why we want to think of this in cycles of 4? Because essentially, when you start dealing with larger powers, you want to figure out how many times is this cycling through and what's left. Let me show you. So if we had I to the 34th and we had to simplify this, right? I would take that exponent of 34 and divide it by 4. I would get 8. And remember remainders back in elementary school? You get to use a remainder again. Remainder of 2. What does this mean? This means we've cycled through 8 times. Cycled through 8 times to get, we essentially got I, you know, we went through, got 1. Because we got, you know, I to the 4th. We got that once, got that twice, got that 3 times, got that 8 times. So you got 8 ones out of this, 1 to the 8th power. And we like that because 1 times itself, no matter how many times, is always going to equal 1. The R here, what does that mean? That means how many I's do you have left after you've cycled through? So we've cycled through 8 times and we're left with 2 I's. Now, those I's, they each represent square root of negative 1, square root of negative 1. And we can even go back to our little key here, because we're left with 2 I's, that leaves us with negative 1. Okay, so that means is I have 1 to the 8th power times negative 1. That's pretty easy. Let's see. 1 to the 8th power is 1 times negative 1 gives me negative 1. So how does this pan out? That tells me that I to the 34th will cycle through 8 times, have 2 I's left, and that simplifies to negative 1. We're going to try another one, too. You notice I already started this one, I to the 97th. I want to figure out how many times it's going to cycle 4 times through to give me how many 1's, right? I figured out, okay, here, this is pretty straightforward. It gives me 24 1's. That means I would have 1 to the 24th power. And guess what? I don't have any remainders left. So I don't have any I's left at that point. So all this is just 1 to the 24th power, which is pretty straightforward. It gives me an answer of 1. And actually, I did something wrong here. So I'm going to double check this because I did... Oh, here's what I got wrong. Always check yourself, folks. 17 minus 16. That's not 16. I get a 1 out of this. And then I'm left with a remainder of 1. What does that mean ultimately? Let me show you. That means I have 1 I left. So I have 1 to the 24th times I to the first. Now, I to the first is negative square root of negative 1. We don't need that. We're just going to leave it as I. 1 to the 24th gives me 1. So ultimately, 1 to the 97th power is going to give me 1 times I, which just simplifies to I. And that's the cool part about this. You just figure out how many times it cycles through 4 times, and then whatever's left over, you refer to your key here, because you're either going to be left over with 1 I, 2 I's, 3 I's. You're not going to be left with 4 I's, because again, it calculates how many times we cycle through. Okay, Let's try another one here. We're going to try a multiplication one because these are pretty straightforward. These are just like adding polynomials. The only difference is we have an I instead of an X. That's all. The multiplication ones can be a bit more tricky, though, so I'm going to try one with you. All right, so you'll notice that we know it's multiplication because we don't have any operations between our binomials. So how am I going to do this? I like to use the box method. This is the way I go. Some people like different methods. They like to use FOIL. That's fine. I'm going to use the box method. If you're one of my students, you've used this before. So now how I do is I just multiply it out. Negative 3 times 5, negative 15. Negative 3 times 6i, negative 18i. 6i times 5, 30i. And then 6i times 6i gives me 36i squared. What I like about this method right here, these are my like terms. So I can just simplify that. Negative 15. And then 30i minus 18i gives me positive 12i. And then I have that 36i squared. Now up above, we remember I squared, we can always replace that with negative 1. So that's what I'm going to do here so I can simplify. 36 times negative 1. And that's pretty straightforward, gives me negative 36. So now I can just combine my like terms, which in this case would be negative 36, negative 15. Negative 51 plus 12i. And I'm done. I've simplified it. Now remember, you want your constant term first, and then you want your I second. All right, I'm going to go through one more with you. Now, when you have I in the denominator, you don't want this. Why? Because I represents the square root of negative 1. You never want radicals in your denominator. That's a big no-no. So how we do that? We use the complex conjugate, fancy term, which means you're going to take that denominator, right? You're going to multiply it by its conjugate, which means you're going to take the same two terms, but you're going to change the operation. So instead of doing negative 8 minus 7i, you're going to do plus 7i. You're going to do the same thing up above, just like so. Why do we do this? Well, let's see. When you multiply binomial by its conjugate, it's a difference of two squares. And you could do it without using the box method, but spoiler alert, you're just going to do the first term squared, which gives us 64, second term squared, which gives us 49i squared, and it's going to be subtraction. And then up above, I can just distribute. 4i times negative 8 gives me negative 32i. 4i times 7i gives me 7i squared. And if we learn from up above, anytime you have an I squared, you replace it with negative 1. Negative 32, I, can't change that. We have the I squared. And I get 7 times negative 1. And I get 64 minus 49. And again, got a negative 1 here, I squared. And I can just simplify. 64 plus 49. Let's see, I have to do it off the top of my head. That'd be 113. So negative 32i. Minus 7. And I'm going to want to write this out in standard form. I just distribute that over 113. So my final answer would be negative 32 over 113i minus 7. And last but not least, like to do this too, folks. Put your constant term first. Negative 7 plus, and we're going to do subtraction here. Instead of, I was going to do plus negative, but I'll just do subtraction. Minus 32 over 113i. There you go. So remember, when you have I in the denominator, you don't want that. Multiply by the complex conjugate. Notice I did the same thing here. I had negative 5 minus I in the denominator. Multiply by negative 5 plus I. And that'll help you get rid of that I in your denominator. So hopefully this helps you with some operations involving imaginary and complex numbers.